Hi Leo, welcome back to Omkara Tarot, and today we'll be doing your July read. Let's see what energies are going to be flowing towards you, my lions and lionesses, in July, and how you can use this read to have a beautiful month ahead. And these are general collective readings, will not resonate with all of you out there. Please take what messages work for you and leave the rest. Okay, so let's begin, Leo. My angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for Leo for July and send them the messages they need to hear the most. Thank you. So Leo, let's begin your reading. Welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you for being here again. And Leo, if you're new here, do join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of us. We welcome you in. All right, Leo. Oh, some big changes coming for you in July, Leo. You're starting something new after a period of stagnation. So let's see what that's going to be. Okay. All right. And the secret message. Okay, Leo. Three of Pentacles, bottom of my spread. I mean, my deck, the overall energy is the Three of Pentacles. Working, maybe, working towards something new. This, I do see something stable and new beginning in your life. So this could be very work and money related here. So let's put this here and see why these cards are here. So your current energy is the Page of Pentacles. Why is that, Spirit? Why is the Page of Pentacles here? Page of Pentacles. Yes, you're all geared up, Leo. You're starting fresh. You're starting very firm, a firm foundation or something brand new. And you're very excited about it. And you're looking good. You're feeling good. You're all charged up. You have all the tools available to you which you need to manifest whatever this thing is that you have in your mind. And yes, you are manifesting something brand new with a lot of passion, a lot of excitement that I see. And this hasn't come easy. It's come after a period of feeling very burdened, feeling very overwhelmed, after you've kind of, maybe in the recent past, you felt very bogged down. Things were very, very, very stagnant maybe in the past with all these burdens that you were carrying. But now I think you're kind of putting a halt to all that. And now see this Page of Pentacles, which was in reverse, is now in the upright in your current energy. So whatever had halted, you want to begin again. You want to be, you know, start stable and new and fresh, and you're manifesting something wonderful for yourself, obviously. And you have a lot of excitement and a lot of gusto going forward as well. So this burdens is you're leaving it in the past. I think you've become very clear-headed. Now it's more about head over heart decisions. You are cutting out things that never served you, all the burdens you were carrying, all the stress you were carrying. You're saying, hey, I've become clear-minded now. I'm no longer going to be sitting in that past energy. I am manifesting something wonderful for myself. And yes, I have all the tools available for me to do so. And I'm going to begin again, and I'm going to manifest something exciting for myself. So now, before I move into the July energies, Leo, I'm going to take a Ganesha oracle card, and let's see this new month of July, which I will read now. What is Lord Ganesha going to bless you with in July? So Lord Ganesha, a blessing for my lions and lionesses out there for July. Insight. Yes, I think a lot of clarity, Leo. You have now figured out what you have to drop, what you have to move forward with, and how you're going to get it. So this is all coming from within, the insight that you have now after a period of struggle maybe. But I mean, from what I see, there are some major changes coming, and there is a huge tower waiting for you in July as well, Leo. Not all towers are not bad, first and foremost, let me tell you that. A tower basically means that anything that is built on not very firm foundation has to go, or there's some sudden changes that happen in your life, which, change your life around. So what's this tower coming for my Leo spirit? Oh my God, no wonder. Okay, King of Pentacles is here, Leo. Whisper, whisper. Okay, so what... love and money both? That's not fair. I mean, it is fair, of course. Good for you, Leo. Yes, there's going to be a reason to celebrate here. After turning your back on something which never worked for you, Leo, I think you're putting the past behind you. In July, there's going to be a sudden transformation, which not only puts you in the seat of power where money is concerned, stability is concerned, but also love. King of Pentacles, King of Cups. It's going to feel like a brand new life from what I see. This is like an exciting brand new journey that you're going to be starting on. Now, don't go by the pictures or the, you know, the gender of these cards. This basically means somebody who's on top of their game where finances are concerned, who is stable. And King of Cups is also that emotions and full heart full of love. This is going to be a start of a brand new journey which is going to make all your dreams come true here. You are being directed in the right direction. And maybe that's because you've been, I think, in hermit mode for some time. You have become a bit spiritual, Leo. Maybe you have been tapping into your insight or your inner knowledge. It's giving you a fresh new beginning, an exciting new start, the one that you've been wishing for. And in July, I see you being directed to the right direction towards making all your dreams come true with money and love. These are the two highest court cards here. King of Pentacles and the King of Cups together. Okay, so what should Leo hold on to, Spirit? Hold on to this card. Just take a picture of this and keep it in your wallet, Leo. This is the Wheel of Fortune. This is luck. This is destiny. This is the Wheel of Fortune. So why should Leo hold on to this, Spirit? Wheel of Fortune. Wheel of Fortune. Wheel of Fortune. Wheel of Fortune. One more. Oh my God. Now listen, you guys, Leos, all of you watching out there, first you need to give me a thumbs up right now, then I'll tell you what I see here. Okay? Okay, you can give it to me later. But the Wheel of Fortune is actually clarified by the Wheel of Fortune. Okay, now this hasn't come easy, or it's not going to come easy, Leo. If you guys have been using your insight or you have been tapping into your spirituality, yes, this is coming. And if you haven't, it's time you went within. It's time, Spirit is saying, all the secrets to your success are inside you. Take some time out, you know, in reflection. There's a story behind this card actually. This actually is a warrior card. The warriors who used to go to war, they used to dig their own grave before leaving and not knowing whether they'll come back dead or alive. And if they came back alive, then they would lie on top of the coffin, put their swords down and reflect and thank the universe for bringing them, you know, back home in one piece. So maybe whatever past burdens you've dropped, you've taken some time out, or you will be taking some time out, and that is going to then your new cycle, new chapter of your life, which is full of happiness. Yes, you need to do a little bit of reflection work from what I see. Of now, what are you going to invest in? What have you been holding on to which has been, you know, keeping you stuck till now? Why have you been so burdened till now? What is it that you've released and what is not what you should carry forward? A little bit of time is required in hermit mode, in the Four of Swords. And yes, and all your inner knowledge that you're tapping into is what is going to take you straight into everything that you wished for. The Tower, it's going to erase everything from the past. I think a brand new life is awaiting you. So what's this Knight of Swords, Spirit? What should Leo let go of? Leo, let go of any rash moves, okay? Don't be too quick. Yes, any conflicts with anyone, I think just now, I mean, no, not just now, but I think now you have to leave all conflicts behind and go and find peace and harmony for yourself within yourself. If you've been in arguments or fights or anything with anyone in the past, you have to let go of that. For you to have your new life begin, you have to now let go of anything that has been disruptive, or if you have, say, anger issues, or you tend to speak out, you know, in anger, or if you are in conflict with anyone, or there is some irritations around you, you have to. Now, this is up to you how soon you can find the balance within yourself and leave any conflict that is in you or around you or in your own head, and start being in a more peaceful state of mind. That this is what is going to bring about the change. Your own insight, you being in your hermit mode and tapping into yourself. All the answers are within you at this moment to change your life. That's what spirit is saying. So, what's going to be the biggest blockage for Leo spirit? Seven of Cups. Why will Seven of Cups become a blockage? Yeah, too many options. Too many options. If you know, sit there and think, what should I do? What, da 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 da. It's going to keep you stuck, Leo. Don't think too much about what happened, why it happened. Let all that confusion go. And instead of thinking too much about what to do next, I think take a leap of faith into the future. It's very scary, I know, to jump off that cliff and hope the universe is going to catch you, but I promise they will. Because this is a brand new life starting from you. There's no point sitting in this past energy of confusion, or, you know, seeing all the options and saying, I don't know whether I want to move yet. There will come a time where you'll have to, you know, enough of this thinking, enough of being hung by a tree and trying to get epiphanies and getting, I mean, you will of course have to spend some time here in this hangman, and or maybe you already are, but soon it's going to become a time where you will have to take a leap of faith and jump into the future. Okay? Otherwise, it'll become a blockage. You'll sit around in that confusion, not wanting to take one step forward because of maybe whatever happened in the past. How are people going to be seeing my Leo spirit in July? People see you as the hermit in July, Leo. Why is that? The wise person. Why do people see my Leo as the. Okay. One more. One more. Ooh. Leo, some people see you as spending a lot of time by yourself, maybe being a bit secretive, or maybe being very emotional, not sharing too much information, and also. Also, keeping some things inside your heart, not sharing too much information. Maybe there could be some people who could think you're a bit in your pride and ego as well. So, just be a little mindful of that, because you know, when people are quiet, other people don't know how to understand why you're quiet, why you're being emotional. People may see you as a little held back or withdrawn, but. This is important for you because that's what spirit is saying. You need this time, but just be a little mindful of not pushing anyone and everybody away while you're going through this time of insight and reflection. Because people could be kind of thinking that Leo's kind of, yes, they also see you as checking out maybe your options, not making any move, delaying moving forward, maybe and is exactly the same card which came out for what's going to be become your blockage. So people may be saying, hey, you know, Leo, it's time for you to check out options, and you may be holding back or saying, no, I want to delay it for some time, I still want to be with myself or by myself. So this is how people are going to be seeing you, as a little kind of confused about your next step and still kind of holding back and maybe keeping secrets or not being very open and preferring your own company. So Spirit, what's the secret message now for Leo for July? Eight of Pentacles. So work's going to be pretty good, it seems, because here I see you working non-stop. What's this, Spirit? Eight of Pentacles. Why is that a secret message? Why is the Eight of Pentacles the secret message from you? Okay. All right. One more. You're putting down a lot of burdens in July, Leo. Anything that was disruptive, anything that you felt was not good for you, I think a lot of clarity is coming to you. You are going to be in a very clear state of mind, state of, after all this maybe reflection work that you're doing, your spiritual guidance that you're getting, I think whatever didn't work for you in the past, whatever was disruptive in your life, whatever you felt was not good for you, I think you're sneaking away from it. You're leaving all that behind, dropping anything and everyone that didn't serve you. I think right now you're focused, absolutely focused on working towards a better future for yourself. And I don't really see you kind of including too many people in this quest. I see one person, head down and totally focused. This is like focus together. King of Swords is like clear-headed. Anything else, Spirit, as a secret message for Leo? Oh my God, Eight of Pentacles clarified by the Eight of Pentacles. So you're going to be working non-stop. I don't know what, Leo. You could be working on your inner self. You could be working on your health, wealth, happiness. I have no clue, but you are single-minded focus in July. So each of you will have a different focus that you're going to be focusing on. This is a collective reading, but the I kind of feel this is work. I kind of feel, because this was the overall energy of our reading as well, the Three of Pentacles. You're coming into your Emperor zone. You're taking back power, taking back control. And yes, and this all has come from the knowledge, or is going to be coming from the knowledge that you hold deep within your own heart, your own mind and your own soul. Right? So don't get confused. You have the answers. All you have to do is tap into that and focus. It's going to be all right. Work, I think, looks really, really good. Eight of Pentacles and the King of Swords. This is like single-minded focus into building something really, really powerful. Okay? So, yes, that's all I have for you for your general read. Leo, hope it worked for you. Till next time then, love and light. Take care. Namaste.